have you been up to?
I've been riding on a daydream.
Hey YouTube, thanks for checking out our channel again, and today Heidi and I is going to go on another walk and explore the camp a little bit more. We might stop at some sites. The campground's slowly filling up. We got people that are leaving and people that are coming. Just to let you know, this entire site is pet friendly, so if you want to bring your pet, you're welcome to do so. We'll have a talk a little bit later about stuff like that. In the meantime, we're going to go check this place out and maybe show you a few more sites. Including sites. I'm talking about the actual site in which you rent, so you can get an idea of what the lot is, and something might strike your fancy a little bit more than what we have or what we've already showed you. That way you can choose that place. So let's go.
We're not that far from our site. Let me turn around and show you. Yeah, you can see our site down there. And wow, look at how long this site is. Number 85. Look how deep that goes back there. It goes back quite a ways. You can see in there quite a ways. There goes that cleaning lady. Her name's Maddie, and she does an excellent job. Hear the woodpecker out there? I don't know if that's picking up on the camera or not. Plus, we have a diesel truck leaving, so that's a little loud. But yeah, this site is really nice. Again, it's electric only, but the pad's pretty level, and there's a lot of trails going off into the woods. And here's the nice thing. Here's the trail to the shower house, and it'll take you to one of the other shower houses. Again, all these shower houses are very, very nice here. There's the trail, but we're not going to go down that trail because we're going to go a little bit further and show you some other sites that may or may not be full, that's right on the water. So we'll go up the road a little ways and pick that up when we get there. Okay, so we didn't get very far. Here's number 84, and I'll have to say it's just as nice as 85. Relatively level pad, very long pad, so you can bring your truck, your trailer, and a car. If it's a motorhome, obviously the towed will work. And there's a trail that goes straight out. I don't know if you can see it. I'll try to hold steady. There's that woodpecker again. But there's a trail straight ahead. I'm sure that takes you to the shower house also. I'll keep this on just so we can check out the next site. You can see how big this one is. There's drinking water. That's a very short pad, a little slopey. That's 83. Oh yeah. If you have a camper or a motorhome that has the opening on the wrong side, this would work. That's kind of interesting. Site number 82. Again, you can see how big the sites are here. You can see why this place does so good. You don't feel like you're packed in. Another pull-through site here. This is number 79. Oh, it's not a pull-through. I'm sorry. It's a back-in. Yeah, you can see these are kind of cool. This one's a real tight little site. That's number 80. We'll show you this site real quick here. It's 78, and it's on the corner of everything. And that one's 77. Again, these are electric only.
These two right here would be perfect for a couple, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Because they kind of come together in the back.
Yeah, you can see all the sites here. This is site number 34. And is that 35? And 36. Okay, 34 and 36. So if you have a group or you have a couple people that want to camp together, this one would be ideal because you guys would be together for sure. You'd have the pad over there and this pad here.
Nice.
Yeah, this is nice and all opened.
Mm-hmm.
Very cool. Even some of these sites, even that site there, it wouldn't be very far to come over to here. All right, we'll continue on down the road. This is number 41. Electric only. You can see how big that is. They got something roped off back there. They must have either a tree down or some sort of nest that they don't want disturbed. That's site 42. All these sites in the middle are okay. I don't know if I'd want to. There is a shower house right there, though. That's what that trail brings you out to. 43. There's a little bit of a slope down towards the water, but you can see the water off in the distance. 45. Not extremely long pads, but... And as far as an awning, I don't know. You'd have some tree situations going on there. We'll go back here. Is there trails going down? Yeah, there's just a big drop-off here, so you can't get all the way down to the water. You can come down to see the water, but you cannot get down to the water. That's for sure. Let you enjoy everything. Now, if you want, you can drive every day, and that, I believe, is the beach over there. It looks like the beach for the entire, for public use, whatever, for but also for the entire campground if you want to do that.
Go ahead and head out back up the hill. You can see this is 52, and it's a real short pad. And it goes down over the cliff. This would be a tough sight to deal with, but you get good views. Looks like you got sunlight back on your picnic table. And there's site 53. Yeah, this is overflow parking, obviously. That's kind of nice that they got it just for this loop. Because the rules are here, which we'll go over, your vehicle has to be on the pad. No tire off, nothing. Boat trailers are the exception. All right, we'll go down around this loop further. Here's 57. That's kind of in a little group area again, where you could have somebody at the next site butt up against you. This is a nice big site. West Branch State Park. Self-registration, cool. Somebody came in last night apparently, whenever they were closed, and did a self-registration. There's like a cliff area back there. But again, these are all electric only. They're not full hookup. This pad looks pretty level. Looks like it slopes slightly down in the back, which is fine if it rains. I'm sure that would help out. And Heidi's going out there to look over the cliff. Looks like they have some caution tape because some of these sites is not kid friendly. I would think that you would have a problem keeping your kids from falling off the edge if they were smaller. Again, if you see straw, that means it's wet. Or it could be wet. Looks like somebody's got some wood here. Not very much of a balance beam, but... It's nice and open. Come back here and enjoy some serious view. Yeah. Yeah, this is definitely straight down. But that's swimming. A lot of that is swimming over there. And during the summer, it's really packed. No floaties. If you got kids, don't be putting floaties on them. Get in trouble. Lifeguards will kick you out. So don't even buy them, unless you got a swimming pool. But it's nice. It's a nice area over there. This would be a good site if you just want to drag your picnic table over and have a nice view of this site. This is number 59. It's got a slope at the beginning, but then it's flat. And this looks pretty ideal. This is a pretty big site. It looks like it would stay relatively dry during the rain. There is some straw over there, so that means it has gotten wet at some point. But look how big this is back here.
This is a big site.
Yeah, this is a really big site. This is huge. I mean, incredibly huge, yeah. It's grassy, it's flat. There might be some water issues here when it rains, but if not, tent for sure. You definitely do tents. And I mean, this is really big. And again, these sites aren't any more than the other ones. They aren't considered premium or anything. I think they're like $26 a night for this site. I don't know about the holidays. Definitely check your rates. I don't know how dated this video is by the time you're watching it. Nice trail. Obviously, if you have a site like this, people are going to occasionally walk along the edges of your site to get to a trail. Most people are pretty polite, and there's a lot of people that won't come past your site if you're there. I mean, we actually invited people. They say, hey, you can walk back here if you want. It's not our property. Now, you can get down to the water here for sure. So this site is becoming more and more better as we go along. You have to do a step down there. It's a little rough once you step down, but you can get to the water. Let's go a little further. You get to the water real easy down this way. Again, the water's really low. I'm sure the water's usually up kind of high. Very nice back here. Boats on the water. It's like a land speeder. Fishing over here. Should do the traditional what everybody does. Catch anything? I love that. Any luck? But yeah, this is got good scenery. You can fish. You can get down to the water, or maybe the water will be higher by the time you're here and you don't have to try to get down. I like this site. I could see where this site could be pretty nasty though when it's windy and cold.
Are you allowed to fish from your camping site?
I don't know why not.
I thought I read something.
Oh, maybe you can't. I know you cannot swim from your site. You only swim at the beach. This looks to be the dam. Sorry about the movement. It says handheld, so. Yeah, it's kind of cool. I agree with Heidi. I think this is probably one of the best electric sites that's here. As far as getting to the water, having a lot of space, having some woods, having privacy, having a big lot, having a level pad. This is probably the best overall. Now that the video's out and about, everybody will want this site. We'll never be able to reserve it. Maybe we'll keep it as our secret. Not. That's why we're doing the video, so you guys can see this stuff. Yeah, this site is incredible. Like I said, if it rains, I'm sure that the mud may make it a little bit more less ideal. God, there's some deer track there. Yeah, we can get down to the water there, too. That's a pretty good site. 62, 63. That's a big site. There's a slope going from the site to the road down, but it's a big site. This is a pretty cool site. 64, number 64. There is a slope in the site going backwards down. The site is deteriorated. As far as the asphalt pad, it's gone away. Obviously, it's electric only. I think all these sites, if they're electric, they're 50 amp. I don't know of any of them that aren't, but we'll look anyways. Yeah. Three power settings there. 50, 30, and your regular 15 amp. But yeah, there's... definitely going to be a water issue here when it rains, except back here. This looks pretty dry. Again, the water's real low, so the water will be a little bit higher possibly when you're here. But yeah, this campsite's nice. I see why that campsite would be pretty decent. There's a boat. You can bring your boat back and hook it up to the tree. You could do that over here too, it looks like. So if you're a boat person.
that's the way to go. Got a picnic table out here. This is nice, shaded. Yeah, you'd be fighting bringing your kids here. Yeah, very nice. Like I said, this cove, I'm sure, is filled with water normally all the way up. This is number 66. It's the one right next to the one we just come from. They got a couple tents there. That's probably a pretty good tent site because the trees protect you quite a bit.
There's two more right here.
Oh, yeah. Just like before, if you have somebody they like to camp with or you want to meet up with, number 67 and probably 69, I'm assuming. These are pretty decent sites. I think that those are probably good tent sites also. This one's a lot more level than that one. That one's a little bit slope, but this one's really flat. Boy, there's a lot of area back there. Number 69. I'm going back here. I'd look at all this down in here. Go to explore. But this is really big back here. Yeah, this is a really huge area. Obviously, again, just electric only. There is some straw, so this gets wet when it rains. Wow, is this really opened up though? This is all for this site. And it's really nice back here. I don't know if you can get down to the water, but you can definitely see the water. Yeah, sweet.
Lovely.
You can get down to the water. You can go down the hill, and it's a steep walk, but you could get down there as long as it's not muddy. This is very nice, though. If you have tents, it's the way to go. Almost makes me wish we still tent camped. This campsite, the pad looks like it slopes down a little bit. It's flat up near the front. It's number 70. And then it slopes down a little bit. Electric only. And there's only one dump station for this entire site. So it's near the going towards the camp store. This is kind of nice. Get your fire ring down there. There's another fire ring right here. It's very small sites, but you got room back there on this one. This one here is not a lot of room. All these sites kind of tie in together.
Yeah.
They're all about the same. As far as getting to the water, I don't think that there's much water at that point. There's a site over here. I would assume these are probably pretty good tent sites. You can see the shower house is right there, so you're not far at all from the shower.
These are all pretty equal, except for that first one. That one had a little bit more.
Ooh, this one's really tight. Number 74. But it does go back. It's kind of private back here. It goes down to what is probably water when the water's up. Not really seeing that now. But nice gorgy area. You could go explore all that. That'd be pretty cool. That's not for us, though. Is it? We're not hikers. Okay, we'll come out this other site. See what it's like over here.
So this is one of the loops that we always like to explore, and we were talking about coming to a few times. Heidi's on her phone, obviously, and we're going to maybe have to reserve back here one day if we're going to do electric only. But all right, we'll close this out and head back for more action later. Bye.